when you are producing something, any work that you do, people work hard, they get exhausted, things happen, you have checklists, but you will still find that some mistakes will slip through. How can we create a process so that these mistakes don't happen again? It's okay to make mistakes once, but don't keep making the same mistakes again and again. So that's where Poka Yoke was introduced. Poka means inadvertent mistake, and Yoke means prevent. How can we prevent mistakes from happening? Let's look at, before we get into examples, I'll just sort of quickly classify the two types of Poka Yokes that exist, and once you see them, you'll be able to start connecting the dots together. There are two types of Poka Yoke devices. The first one is what is called control Poka Yoke, and the second one is what is called warning Poka Yoke. Now, in a control Poka Yoke, the process is designed in such a manner that you would not be able to make a mistake. You would actually go through the process step by step yourself without even realizing what's going on, what's happening, and you'd get the right thing done. There is no chance of an error occurring in that process. And the other process is a warning Poka Yoke, which means that the moment the error occurs, it's going to flash some sort of a message to you or some sort of a warning to you to tell you, oops, looks like you made a mistake. Right? So these are these two categories. Ideally, in an ideal world, we would like things to never go wrong, right? So we would try and aim for control Poka Yokes as much as possible, but you would automatically, as we proceed through the talk, realize instances where it makes more sense to have warning Poka Yokes rather than having control Poka Yokes. So let's look at some of the examples in the manufacturing industry. Let's say I have the engine which is going to be very hot. I have some sort of a component that's really hot, and I want to make sure that I make use of bolts which are heat resistant. But I have other bolts also which I'm using for my manufacturing process, right? How do I ensure that the worker doesn't go and screw on the wrong bolt? You'll screw on the wrong bolt, everything will work fine right now, but after some point in time when it gets hot, that bolt is going to break, crack, melt, something is going to happen. So you're going to go and have to check, right, later down the line, okay, did the guys use the right bolt? So what you would do, a simple solution most of us will come up with, let's color code it, right? So let's color code the bolt and I'll immediately know. But what if a person is so, there are people, by the way, who cannot distinguish colors. You won't even come to know, but there are people, it's difficult to believe. So a more elegant solution to this is make the size of the bolt slightly different from all the other bolts. That's quite simple. Now he's not going to be able to put the wrong bolt in. It becomes a control Poka Yoke mechanism. So you make the heat resistant bolts, which are most likely going to be the more expensive components of your parts, slightly different in size from all the other bolts. It will work both ways. Those bolts will not fit in a low expensive place, and it will also work in the right place, right? So it sort of has a nice healthy size.